Welcome to this spoken tutorial on mathematical typesetting in LaTeX. My name is Kannan Modgalya. A reminder, we should call it LaTeX and not LaTeX. In this tutorial, we will learn how to create mathematical symbols in LaTeX. In particular, how to get into and leave from the mathematical mode, the role of spaces and creating them, mathematical symbols, finally, AMS math package and its use in creating matrices. I am creating this tutorial on our less than 10,000 rupee laptop. I am using Ubuntu, TechWorks and LaTeX. The prerequisites are the following. Basic spoken tutorials on LaTeX. Exposure to the side-by-side tutorial. All are available from our website. I shall use the file maths.tech. It is available as a code file in our web page where you found this tutorial. In the same location, you will find this PDF file from the Tech User Group India. We shall use it when we do assignments. Let me go to the TechWorks window. I have already opened the file maths.tech. Please download this file and practice along with me. We have already seen the commands that are at the top of this file. This command removes the paragraph indent. We will study the effect of this statement through an assignment. Let us start with Greek symbols that are used in mathematics. We use dollar sign to get into mathematical mode in LaTeX. Let us begin with alpha. We write dollar backslash alpha dollar. Let us compile and see that we get the Greek letter alpha in the PDF. The first dollar says that we are getting into the mathematical mode. The second dollar says that we are leaving this mode. From now on, I will not explicitly mention dollar or the backslash. But you have to do exactly what you see on the screen. Similarly, we write beta, gamma and delta. Let us compile. I did not save the tech file as TechWork does it automatically. Let us delete these. We will next take up the concept of spaces in mathematical expressions. How do we generate alpha A, that is the product of alpha and A? Let us try alpha A. Let me compile. LaTeX complains that alpha A is an undefined control sequence. It says that it does not understand this command. Let me close this. LaTeX handles this through a space after every command. Let us leave a space after alpha. Let us abort the compilation. Let's recompile. This has solved the problem. As it is used to terminate a command, the space does not appear in PDF. What do we do if we want to introduce spaces in the output? We have to explicitly tell LaTeX as we do now. Let us ask LaTeX to start a new line. Let us write alpha backslash space A. Compile it. This has created a space. If you want more space, use quad as we do now. Compile it. You can see that quad has left a large space. We will now move to another topic. Let us delete the last two lines. Let's compile. What happens to the font when we go from the text to the mathematical mode? To understand this, let us write product of alpha and A is Compile. You can see that the font of these two A's are different. This is solved by writing this A also inside dollar signs. Let me compile. Now the fonts of these two A's are identical. Not keeping the font of variables identical is a common mistake. Let us get rid of these. Let's compile. Let us now discuss a rule for creating minus signs. Suppose that we want to create minus alpha and compile. Let's compile. Notice that the minus sign appears as a small dash here. Let us also copy with the minus sign inside the dollar sign. Let us compile again. See the difference in the minus sign now. The second one is what we need. The dash is not to be used. Not putting the minus sign within dollars is a common mistake made by beginners. Let us delete all of these. Next, we would like to explain the frac command that is used to create fractions. Frac A B. Let's compile. It generates A by B. The command frac is terminated by a space. It looks for two arguments. The first character A is taken as the first argument. It becomes the numerator. The second character B is taken as the second argument. It becomes the denominator. Notice that the size of A and B gets reduced automatically. What do we do if we have longer characters? What if we want to create AB by CD? I want you to try this. In LaTeX, the arguments longer than one character are enclosed by braces. For example, let us put braces here. When we compile this, we get the desired output. All the entries within the braces are taken as a single argument. As a result, one can enter any complicated expression within braces. Let us delete all of these. Now we will look at subscripts and superscripts. X underscore A creates X sub A. The size of A gets automatically reduced to an appropriate level. What if you want to put AB as the subscript? You have to use braces. Try it yourself. Superscripts are created by the caret or the up arrow symbol. For example, if you want to create x to the power 3, you will write x up arrow 3. We can also put subscripts and superscripts simultaneously. Let us put x sub A superscript B. Let's compile. Once again, using braces, we can produce complicated subscripts and superscripts. Let me delete this. Alright, next we will move on to matrices. The package AMS Math has some matrix definitions that I like. Let us include it through the use package command. The ampersand, that is the AND symbol, is used to separate the columns. Let us create a matrix now. We write begin matrix, A and B, end matrix. Don't forget the dollar signs. Compile and see the matrix as expected. Now suppose we want to add a second row to this. We put two backslashes, meaning go to the next line. Suppose that we want three entries in the second row, say C, D, E. compile it and see the second row also included now. Supposing we change matrix to P matrix at begin and end. Compile and get this. It is now time for you to start exploring. Let us go to the slides now. Let us summarize what we learnt in this tutorial. Entering and leaving the mathematical mode, using spaces and creating them, fractions, subscripts and superscripts, defining an argument within braces, AMS math package to create matrices. Let me give some assignments. This assignment is on spaces, large and small. Please pause the video, read the slide and do the assignment. This assignment is on fractions using braces. This assignment is on subscripts and superscripts. Through this assignment, we shall learn a few more methods to create matrices. This assignment is on creating more mathematical symbols. This is based on the TUG India LaTeX guide. Let us see the document now. I already asked you to download this document from our webpage. You will reproduce some symbols given in this document. You will try out more symbols in the next assignment. This assignment is also based on the TUG India document. You will experiment with the paragraph indent in this assignment. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. This video summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you may download and watch it. We conduct workshops using spoken tutorials, give certificates, please contact us. Do you have questions in this spoken tutorial? Please visit this site. Choose the minute and second where you have the question. Explain your question briefly. Someone from our team will answer them. The spoken tutorial forum is for specific questions on this tutorial. Please do not post unrelated and general questions. This will help reduce the clutter. With less clutter, we can use these discussions as instructional material. For topics not covered in spoken tutorials, visit Stack Exchange at this address. This is a great place to get answers on LaTeX. You may also have questions on our workshops, certificates, etc. For this, get in touch with us at this email address. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by NMEICT, MHRD, Government of India. Thanks for joining. Goodbye.